Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. As we are ending Ramadan, unfortunately, it is sad. We have to now think about what have we achieved in Ramadan, what are the great things that we have managed to accomplish, and that could include the things that we've started to do, extra, the things that new practices that we've incorporated into our lives, and what are the things that we stopped doing of bad habits. And those are the things that we need to think about today, and then think how can we carry on those practices outside Ramadan, because that's what it's all about. This whole aspect of 30 steps towards a refreshing Ramadan means that this Ramadan is refreshing, but what comes after Ramadan is built on as well, because we know that a lot of things are gonna stop after Ramadan. The chaining of the shayateen, the doors of Al-Jannah are going to be closed again, and so on and so forth. So we're going to be left to our own devices once again. And we have to make sure that we've used the best opportunity to make sure that the rest of the year, and the rest of the years in fact, have been positive and all built on. So look at all the things that you've achieved, your salah, your Quran, your dhikr, your fasting, all these things that you've done extra, the useful apps that you've downloaded, the conflicting apps that you got rid of, all those things, how can you maintain them after Ramadan? So just think about that. Think about what you've done extra and make sure that you write those down, maybe write at least three things down that you want to maintain for after Ramadan. Inshallah, that will help you to achieve more throughout the year. And remember, a sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepting the good deeds is more good deeds. And a sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has caused or is punishing for a bad deed is a bad deed after that as well. So it becomes almost like something that's perpetual. So I hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you and me the ability to carry on with our good deeds, starting with the fasting of 6 of Shawwal, and to maybe incorporate regular fasting in our schedule, to incorporate more Quran, to incorporate more remembrance of Allah, more charity, more good deeds, more good moral behavior, etc. And as we are coming to the end of the program, please do include myself and Sundus, the authors of the book, in your dua, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts from us and from you this great work, and that inshallah we hopefully see you in the coming days, in the coming weeks, in other programs. Take care, stay safe, and Eid Mubarak. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.